The muzzle flash effect is a really easy effect even for beginners. What is it that separates this from this? Today, I'll show you how to composite muzzle flashes into DaVinci Resolve and little tricks to make them look even more realistic, thanks to today's sponsor, ProductionCrite. They have a ton of both free and paid muzzle flashes on their website, which we will be using today. In addition to that, they have over 10,000 video assets for any video project. ProductionCrite has been my one-stop shop for almost 2 years now, thanks to their high-quality assets and ever-growing library. Check out the link in the description to sign up for a free account today or upgrade to one of their affordable annual subscriptions. Now, let's get started. The first step to creating muzzle flashes is of course to import your clip. And once it's imported, then you want to create it into a Fusion composition. To do that, we'll right click and then do New Fusion Clip. Now, if we go over into the Fusion page, we can see we have a media in and a media out. But now we need to add in our muzzle flash. I will link the muzzle flash that I'm using down in the description, as well as a free one that you can use. To import it, all you need to do is drag it into Fusion and it will add in a brand new media in. If you hit 1 to view it off on the first viewer, you can see our muzzle flash. Now muzzle flashes should only be visible for one frame. So if your muzzle flash is visible for more frames, add in a time speed node and you can adjust the speed of it and speed it up so that it only lasts for a single frame. But since this one is all ready to go, all I have to do is merge it up with our media in. Now I'll skim through this clip and find the frame that I want the gunshot to appear on. Now if I open the keyframes editor and click on my media in 2, and what I'll do is I'll just drag it over until the muzzle flash appears on this frame. And let's add in a transform node after the media in. From here, I can grab it and move its position around and then scale it down. Ideally, you want the muzzle flash to be about the same size as the gun. Now, because I'm shooting at a little bit of an angle here, the perspective of this muzzle flash doesn't look quite right. Now, the way I go about fixing this is unchecking the size and aspect and adjusting the X and Y sizes independently. And from there, you can get a more unique looking muzzle flash and one that kind of matches your perspective just a little bit more. Now, another way to make it look more realistic is to add some smoke and sparks after your muzzle flash is dissipated. Now, the ones from ProductionCrite have that built in, so I don't need to do anything. But if you want to add some of your own, just use the same steps of importing them using the transform and keyframes editor, and just make sure to put it in about the same position. And once you've done that, you can copy these nodes and add a muzzle flash to all of your gunshots in the scene. And now we want to add in some glow. To do that, let's select all of our muzzle flashes here and hold down Shift and drag up. This will disconnect it from our node graph. Now let's add in a background node and connect it up into the merge node. Make sure this background node is set to be completely transparent. Now if we view this last merge node here, we can see we have all the muzzle flashes on a transparent background. From there we can merge it up with the original media in and add in a glow node after the merge with shift space. Now go to a frame where there's a muzzle flash and we can start playing with the settings. I like to crank the glow size up to something like 400 and then bring the glow amount to about 9.5. Another thing you can add is a second glow node, but this time only adjust the X scale. Bring the Y scale all the way down and bring the X scale up to about, let's say 80. I'll also bring down the blend just to so it only appears in certain spots. Bring down the glow. Just mess around with the settings until you get these little streaks coming off of the muzzle flare. Now, to make this match our original footage, we're going to add in some film grain. So after the first glow node, add in a film grain node. And now every shot is different, but I had to bring all of my settings here down. And now if you look at this, it matches our original shot quite well. Now one final way to improve this is to come to the final merge node here and change the apply mode to be hard light. So that just kind of brings up the saturation and I think it makes it look a lot better. Now another way to make the muzzle flash look even more realistic is to make it interact with its environment. How we'll do this is by dragging the media in all the way off to the side here and adding in a color corrector node. Now we can add in a B-spline mask and I'm gonna do my face first here. So what I'll do is I'll just make a rough outline of my face. Now if I put this into the color corrector, I can come in here and bring up the gain and lift settings just to kind of brighten it up just a little bit. As you can see, we have this hard edge and to fix that, I can just come into the B-spline and add a soft edge. In the color corrector, I wanna add a little bit of a tint just by dragging it over, just to give it more of a warmer feel. I can also play with the saturation and bring that up just a little bit. I don't want to do too much. And then playing with the gain and lift settings. And a lot of times I like to make this be a little bit more over the top, and I'll show you why in just a minute. Since my face doesn't need quite as much glow on it, I can bring the level down inside of the mask until it's something a little more manageable. Now to make this turn on and off when the gun fires, We'll go into the color corrector node and come over to the blend. We'll just add a keyframe on it, go one frame backwards, bring it down to zero, and then go one frame after and bring it down to zero. So now my face will just light up for a second after shooting the gun. And if it seems too intense, just bring this level down just a little bit more and keep doing that until you get something that you like. Now go through and add in a bunch of beast blind nodes and make it light up all the different spots of your body, like your hands, your arms, your chest, and make sure to play with the level so the stuff closer to the gun is brighter than the stuff farther away from the gun. Now to make this affect all the gunshots, just bring the blend up whenever the gun fires, and then you can just go through using all of your existing masks and just touch up their position based on any little movements that you did. All right, now one thing to make it look better is to have the gun move here, all right? So if we go to frame, let's say 7, we want to find a good spot where the gun has like no motion blur on it. We'll copy the media in and view it off to the side. Then we'll add a time speed node and set the speed to be 0 and the delay to be the frame that you found, so frame 7. If we view this, it'll always be stuck at frame 7. We can add in a polygon node and trace out the top part of the gun here. And now if we connect that up into the media 1, we can see we have that part of it isolated. We can add a little bit of a soft edge here, like that, and then we can merge this up on our media in. Now we want to go back to the first frame that we have a muzzle flash, and we'll bring the blend all the way up. Go one frame forward, bring the blend down, one frame after, bring the blend down again. After that, we can add in a transform node and scale it up so it fits the original position. Then we'll just drag it back just a little bit and finally add in a directional blur. We'll add this after the time speed. We'll set the type to be centered and then bring the length up. Now, since this isn't perfectly centered, we can bring this position and just put it right in the middle of the gun here. And now it will scale right off the center there, just to give it some nice motion blur. And we can adjust the angle just to make sure it matches with the original gun here. And once again, just duplicate the transform and the merge node and do this for every frame. Now all that's left is to add in some awesome sound effects and your effect is done. You can get those sound effects off of Production Crate as they have a huge sound effects library as well. Make sure you sign up to Production Crate with the link down below. But that's it for this tutorial. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to give it a like and subscribe so you never miss out on any content in the future. Let me know if you guys have any questions down in the comments below. And with that being said, I'll see you guys next time for another video.